For 25 years, Dave Sanders' gentle heart and selfless spirit were as much a part of Columbine High School as the flower that gave the school its name.
Aside from his family, this was his life. Just being around kids, this was just what made him a whole person. This is where he could thrive.
It wasn't just, okay, I'm going to coach people. It was, these are my adopted daughters, these are my adopted boys and kids, and I really care about what's going on.
Fly, fly, little wing, fly beyond imagining.
Dave never knew his own father, losing him to a heart attack when he was just 3. With a love for sports, but with no strong male influence to guide him, he gravitated to his high school basketball coach, a kind and generous man named L. Harden. As the bond between them grew, it inspired Dave, setting the course for his life.
He said if he could touch just one student the way Al Harden had touched him, he would feel like he was successful.
He was my coach and he was a teacher too, but he was like more like a friend and like a father figure for all of us girls.
The thing that most people don't realize, and this happens quite a bit, I, especially with Christy Held and Amber Burgess, have probably spent more time with them in the last 4 years than even mom and dad.
Just weeks before his death, Dave joked about the endless hours he devoted to his players, coaching 6 different sports over the years. As much as his evident passion, though, it was his compassion that distinguished him.
I had been crying, and I remember I came out of the locker room, and he sat down with me, and he's like, you know, what's going on, and do you need a day off? Do you just need to hang out? Are you okay? I'm here for you, and gave me a big hug like my dad would.
Those were his kids, and he was going to do whatever he had to do to make sure that his kids were okay.
At that time, I heard some gunfire go off. Dave was the very first to react.
Seeing the gunman outside, Sanders had raced to the front of the cafeteria, jumped on a chair, and alerted more than 450 students to take cover.
He yelled into the group of hundreds of people, get down.
Get down, get down, leave your things and move out.
He just kept saying, you know, get out of the building as fast as you can, you know, hurry, just get out.
I looked back and last time I saw him, he was running up the stairs.
And as David was running toward me, that's when he was shot. You hear the gunfire and you see him fall. And he said, I'm not doing very well. I just don't know if I'm gonna make it.
I told Mrs. Miller and the kids to kiss his daughters for him and tell him that he loved him. He had time to be able to do that.
Leave this lonely world of ours. Escape the sorrow and the pain. And fly again.
He was just an amazing person. He really was a gift in that he had so much love in him that he would risk his own life to be in order to save all those other kids' lives.
I've gotten cards and letters from parents saying I can kiss my son or daughter goodnight tonight because of your husband.
Dave Sanders was my favorite grandfather. He always used to give us hugs and kisses before we went to bed.
Do not fear, don't waste the breath, don't shed a tear.
Dave Sanders died that day at Columbine, just as he had lived every other day in his 25 years there, putting kids before himself.
The moon will rise, the sun will set, but I won't forget.
I won't forget anything about him. And I hope that people can see what a great man he was and what an impact that he had on our school and on the whole nation, hopefully. He was a really special man.